wanted to address that a number of people had issues with, and that is the compressed period of time for this committee to be deliberating. And so I wanted to explain why that is. The superintendent of schools and Chief Rossler would like very much for us to be able to complete amendments or revisions to the memorandum of understanding in time for the next school year. And so if you start to count back from that period of time, the Board of Supervisors and the school board don't meet in August. And so for that reason, I would like for us to try real hard to try to provide recommendations that can be considered so that when the superintendent and the chief of police are then bringing a revised or amended MOU to our respective boards, they have the advantage of hearing from the community, which is what this this committee is all about. So anyway, I just wanted to explain that because I know I heard from some folks who said, why are we artificially, you know, moving this along so quickly? And mainly we would like to be able to have this in time for the next school year. And that's what they have some issues or problems with. So we'll have that opportunity next week. Again, if we still need more time, the world won't come to an end. We just won't have time to be able to put this in place before the next school year. So with that, I am going to sit down, behave myself, turn things over to Shirley Denwright.
Thank you, Chairman Vogel. Okay, so last week you provided three documents. One was the redlined version of the memorandum of understanding. You also provided a link to a forum that was held a couple weeks ago that talked about the SRO roles and responsibilities presented by Diana from the Virginia State Criminal Justice, Department of Criminal Justice Services. And you also provided a copy of the Virginia School Law Enforcement Partnership Model Memorandum of Understanding to look at, which could possibly help you with clarity on some of the comments or some of the sections within the draft organization. We have a lot of members around the table, so I think it's important that we go around some house rules. We will respect each other as we go around the table with comments. We have a limited time. Meeting tonight is 2 hours, so we don't want anyone to try to monopolize the conversation, and everyone needs to have an opportunity to speak. There are 51 pages of documents, of comments. There were a lot of general comments that did not reference whether there was an addition or deletion. As a result, there was nothing we could really do with those, as the requirement was to identify the page, the paragraph, and the action that you wanted to take, as opposed to leaving it up to us to do that, or leaving it up to Dr. Brayban or Chief Rossler's staff to do that. As we go through this document, what I would like to do, not look at wordsmithing the document, but let's look at the substance. A lot of the comments were related to the same theme. It was just worded differently. So what I did, I took the liberty of trying to pull together all of those comments that were related and then discuss those. And we're going to have a document on the front. We're going to have a document, the Memorandum of Understanding Committee Review. And that's the page we're going to be making our changes on. And at the end of the day, we will provide that document to the Fairfax County Public School, Dr. Brayban and Chief Rossler. So like that, Diane, you have to come.
Yes, first I am Diane Alejandro. I'll be representing ACLU People Power at this meeting, and appreciate the opportunity to. I wonder, before we get into the specifics, we could address the point that the chairman raised about the process, because it is helpful to understand why. I'm not sure that it makes that process any more open, transparent, and educated, an educated process. So I wondered if we could address that first.
Okay, which process are you talking about?
The whole SRO review, not just having three meetings, but we have the normal, if you look at the recommendations,
Okay, we're going to go through the recommendations.
No. Recommendations for process that are set out by the Department of Justice and others. They say that the first step in an SRO review process should be an examination of what is happening in the schools now, what the data shows as far as racial, ethnic breakout, disparity with the disabled, all the data that is available, so that the group is informed of what is really going on before we try to make recommendations to change it. And that has not been presented to this group. I think that's an important element of doing that. And there is just so much information that needs to be absorbed by these members. Some of us have been working on this issue for quite some time, some have not. And I think to get the best input from everyone, we need to be on the same page in terms of level of education and process. And honestly, three meetings is not going to be enough, and 1 week with the holiday to get comments in is really not enough. But the first step is education and data, and we have yet to see that.
Last week, there was some education on that, and Chief Wasser sent out some information last week as well.
There was no data, was there?
We did not provide data on, because we're not talking about, and I assume you're talking about data pertaining to the school to prison pipeline. Is that the data you're talking about?
We have data that's been presented by the NAACP. We have data that ACLU People Power has put together. There are multiple studies about disciplinary data in these schools in Fairfax specifically. And there is data at the school level showing this to be perhaps one of the worst states in the country. Now, all that needs to be understood, and it's not to say that that data cannot be explained, but the explanation that's been heard so far is not satisfactory. For example, the incident reports I've looked at, Marcy has looked at 16 of them, and we've discussed them together.
Okay, hold on.
Just to say, there's a lot of data there. There's holes in the information that's been presented, and I think we need an opportunity to look at what's there.
Okay, I definitely agree with that. We need the extended time so that we can process this information and to be able to digest so much information that we've just been given over the weekend.
Okay. There is, I understand what you're saying. However, I think because we do have comments from a lot of the other members, that we proceed to go through those comments, and we can. It's not saying that you cannot still understand that data. If I don't know what the NAAC presented to you, or what you have as data.
We've personally examined it as well.
Okay, but my recommendation right now is that we proceed with the comments that we have. The 51 pages of comments that we received from other members of the committee.
Okay, there's one other point of order after Sukyong, because it relates to that.
For us, very much in line with what Diane and Tina have shared, I question what Like, is there something motivating this, like, incredibly speeded up process? Like, are we gonna be in violation of something if we don't get something done by, like, August or September? Like, I just don't, not really under, and again, like, I sit here in this room again today. I literally see no young people at this table. Are there, I don't know if there are any Fairfax County Public high school students or middle school students in the audience. Okay, this is like a somewhat fairer improvement, but again, like, not really sure, but I think, you know, as Diane made the point around the data, there's also this point around, I mean, it just seems like to be a best practice to get input, meaningful input from young people. And so, if just trying to really understand the motivation of, like, why this needs to get done in 3 weeks.
Okay, you may not have been here, when you just made the comment.
Oh, I didn't mean that, okay.
So if I could just, let me just say again, the purpose for us to try to complete this process, or at least as much as we can, first of all, already there is a process underway to amend the memorandum of understanding that our police have with the school system. So already there is a memorandum of understanding. The SRO program has been in existence for a number of years, but the chief and the superintendent are interested in updating that, and they've had some conversations, for instance, with the NAACP, and many of those recommendations have been accepted and have been incorporated into an amended MOU. This is not a board of supervisors committee. This is something that I suggested, that we put the community's eyes on this program, and mainly on the MOU. So this was not established by the Board of Supervisors. This was established by me, and I asked Shirley, as the chairman and president of the Communities of Trust, if she would chair a number of meetings so that we could ask the community. You know, first of all, last week was an educational opportunity for everyone to see what is the program, what is the current MOU, what are some statistics regarding youth and crime in our schools. So we had an educational opportunity, and I cautioned everyone not to jump into making recommendations until we had at least some education regarding the program. I hope that we are able to provide some guidance to the chief and to the superintendent as they're finishing the process of amending the MOU. If that doesn't happen, you know, they're doing this, and I would very much like for the community to be able to take a look, make some recommendations if you have recommendations. If you choose not to do that, or if you want to, you know, not have a community process, we don't have to do that. This is not something that the Board of Supervisors has
decided. You're the one who's chosen not to have a community process.
I'm sorry, but I'm talking to the committee, and we'll not have folks calling out who are here.
So you're saying explicitly that you're not including the community.
All right, so with that little preamble, I'm gonna turn things back over to Shirley. We've
Excuse
had a
me.
Lot on
okay.
our plate.
One point of order, because it does go toward the process. I asked Clayton to give us your legal counsel's opinion as to whether this committee is subject to open meeting rules. And we would like to hear from counsel as to an explanation why or why
okay,
not.
Okay, Diana, counsel is not here. And as the committee chair, I'm going to move this meeting forward with the comments that the other committee members have put together. As Chairman Bova stated, the memorandum of understanding is already in place. We can provide comments to improve that, or we can continue with the one that's already in place. Yeah, Chief Russell.
Dr. Brayman and I want to make significant changes before the school year starts. We have to train all the SROs and the principals. And I know this might take a little bit longer, but the current MOU needs change, and that's our goal, is to make significant change. And the two of us are willing to be open to continue to make this change. And three meetings might not be enough, but we need to make real big changes to this so the community has confidence and trust that we're doing the right thing. So I stand here willing to continue with the change process.
The one thing I would share is, I was gone for 5 years, I've come back to Fairfax County. The issue about the school to prison pipeline was something that took place while I was away. I was in another school district in Virginia. It was certainly an issue across the Commonwealth. We changed our MOU there. In the first year back, I've agreed to make SRO MOU changes. Nothing is saying that this thing is etched in stone like the Ten Commandments. I listened to you and I'd ask you respectfully, I didn't make looks, I'd ask you to do the same thing for me. Okay? I'm here to have an honest dialogue with this committee and this community. We're willing to make changes. We've already put down some significant changes, and obviously there's feedback and interest in more. What I would suggest is the spirit of, let's see how much we can get done tonight and on Monday, and I'd rather have a better SRO MOU to start the year than just using the old one we have. The training that we have set up starts for our school system and our administrators early in August. And both boards, which have to support the MOU, have recesses in them. So it's really about, are we going to get something done that would impact this coming school year? Or we could spend a longer time and go through more of the data we could and wait a whole nother year. I'd rather make the SRO MOU better. And if there's still things that are left unaddressed or a lack of consensus about, let's identify those and work on them through the year to affect the 19-20. So there's nothing, again, it was a 5 years ago, it was done by a prior superintendent. I don't know, were you chief then, Ed, about? We can continue to look at it as often as the community and our boards and you all think is necessary. So I would approach it with that spirit. I think what we're going to do today and next week is going to give us something that's better than what we had before. And, I hope we'll keep that in mind as we go through. I'm here to listen. There's a lot of interesting ideas in here. We had worked already on some interesting ideas. I think we can create a better MOU now, get both of our board support, and begin implementing that to see real change for next year instead of waiting another year to see some of those changes come through.
So I think a lot of people have put a lot of thought in some of this thing, and it's as you say, the MOU exists. It's either going to continue as it is, or you sort of take in input, however incomplete as it is. But one of the things that I noticed in that we're trying to change in this MOU, and you've emphasized it several times, is that there is continuous meeting to review what is in the MOU and the effectiveness of the SRO program. I would suggest that that is the response to many of the issues here. We can continuously look at it, update it, give you more impact or more input. And the idea that this is the only time for us to get the SRO program exactly right, we try to do our best now, but I think that built into the comments section, and we could even re-emphasize those parts that says, let us meet annually, which I think was something you emphasized last week, and combine, make sure that those become really substantive, meaningful, continuous dialogue about, this didn't work last year, these are the trends, these are the data, and these are what we anticipate could be future problems, and this is what we ought to do in terms of putting into place things that address it. So I don't see this as the last goal to develop policies or even tactics about how to do things. In fact, I see some of the recommendations reinforcing the idea that there is a continuous review of the effectiveness of the SR program. So unless you are suggesting that we eliminate the SR program, I think that we should go over. Okay. You know, just continue.
Yep. I have a question, Dr. Penner, follow up with the gentleman here. If we put the MOU in place at the beginning of the school year, are you suggesting that we have to wait for another 4 year before we can make maybe an amendment or a change to the MOU?
No, the chief and I were just talking about that. I think we could be open to that depending on what the amendment was and the scope of it. I think the best leverage point to actually get effective implementation is to begin the year when we have our principals and SROs together in the room. It just gets harder during the school year to pull people out to do training. It can be done, Randy, it can. But I think it just gets harder. And it's much like our SR&R, our own student rules and responsibilities document, we try to have that done with no amendments during the year. It just makes it more seamless. But it doesn't mean that if as Ted said, we create some sort of ongoing process and something gets raised that's unresolved by next Monday, we can spend time doing some work on that and have that as something that gets amended later or something that we need to do additional information on. One thing, and Marcy, I agree with you about is our own education. I think we do need to do a better in education. People have their own points of view, which that's gonna happen in a big system, even a small system. But we need to do better to share and create shared space to learn together. The state has been having, and they're having for their third or fourth year, Governor McAuliffe called it the School to Prison Pipeline Conference. It's called the Equity Conference this year. Fairfax County is sending a team, as we have in previous years, to continue to learn. And it's usually educators and some of our police officers in the room together. And I think we've got to create that sort of community dialogue here. We're going down to Richmond and listening there and coming back. And maybe that's in the end. This is the beginning. Maybe it wasn't the perfect design. It was a quick summer rush, but it helps plant the seed for a more sustained community conversation around these topics.
But just quickly to follow up, it just seems to me that it would be a good compromise if we do as much as we can within the 3 days that is allowed it. And then if that is not sufficient, we look to, you know, come back before a whole nother year and do some amendments.
And just to maybe an amendment to that amendment, will you all commit, if it is determined that this should have been subject to the open meeting rules, and there's a compelling legal argument why it should have, that you will immediately and not next year, but immediately hold public meetings, open meetings, so that these can follow the procedures that are set forth by Virginia law.
I'm not the expert on that, and you bringing it up today is the first I've heard. The chairman of the Board of Supervisors asked me to attend 3 meetings in July, and I said, yes, ma'am. that's the truth.
And
next to your wife.
So that's what I'm here to do, attend these meetings and share the work that Ed and I have been working on.
So I asked our county attorney if she would opine on whether or not this constitutes a public body. And if it does constitute a public body, then are members of this committee subject to freedom of information requirements? For instance, 2 of you cannot get together and talk about this committee and the committee work without being in violation of FOIA. More than two of you. Also, if this body were subject was under FOIA, we would have to advertise publicly that this was going to be a meeting. And we haven't done that. We've advertised it to you guys. This is what the county attorney says. First of all, she doesn't have a complete answer, but she said that the general framework for the FOIA analysis is as follows. It does appear that the committee may not be subject to FOIA, as you suspected. I suspected it wasn't because I convened it, not the whole board of supervisors. However, one of the things that I wanted to nail down is whether or not the committee was organized to provide any sort of advice to the Board of Supervisors as a whole. For example, if the revised MOU drafted by the committee would be presented to the Board of Supervisors for approval, which we're planning on doing, with the recommendation of the committee. That would dictate in favor of finding it to be a public body, even though the members were not appointed by the entire board. Perhaps for purposes of this evening, so this is advice I got today, we could stick with saying that it does not appear to be a public body, but we have not yet finalized our opinion. So that does it. Secondly, so we'll find out if we are a public body. Again, we will have a little bit of education regarding what your rights and your responsibilities are under FOIA. Also, all of your contact information is subject to FOIA. So if anyone asks for your contact information, I'm under the obligation to provide that to whoever asks. So I just wanted to make sure that everyone understands that. So anyway, stay tuned. We'll find out more in the meantime. I think everyone should just be a little bit careful about, you know, about how we conduct ourselves.
Okay. Can I ask the people with the signs to lower them because you're blocking the people in the back of the room?
You're blocking democracy.
We're
going
to see.
I'm sorry, let's go for Tina, and then we need to move forward.
Okay, thank you. I think this is a great opportunity to have a collaborative process with our community, and for me, that's what's trying to happen. At the top of this meeting, it was said that you've heard from many people about their concerns with this process and the lack of time. We are part of this community. This committee is part of the community. It sounds to me like the committee is saying there's not enough time at the top of this meeting.
You're here.
Essentially, we've had three meetings. The first one was just to listen. We got some information. This one is to discuss, and then our last one will be to decide. So to me, this just feels like our very first meeting because we didn't get the information. We didn't get the MOU that we requested ahead of time, and it just feels like it's just now starting. So essentially, we have this one meeting to get all this information together, process, discuss, and I'm going to assume that when this was originally put together, it took more than 2 or 3 hours. Mm-hmm. So we need more of that too if we're going to truly do good work with this.
Hear, hear. Okay. And I think Dr. Brayman has mentioned that this is not the end, but if we can make recommendations to improve what we have now, then we do that. We can do that. And then come back and up to have the document updated at another time. But a lot of people, other than a few, made comments on the document. And with that, I'd like to move forward on those and acknowledge those and thank those who did make the, their comments. We're going to be flipping back and forth on different documents. There are a lot of understanding committee review comment sheet. There were a lot of comments that were received. Like I said, there were 51 pages, and some of the comments were the same. What I did as the chair, took the liberty to look through all of those, and we're going to flip back and forth on the document. Included who submitted the comments on those sections. There were some sections that there were no comments on. This is not a completed document. There were some sections that there were no comments on, so therefore they would not be updated. And then there's some sections that, and all of these are still open for discussion from the committee of anything that we need to change. So what I'm going to do is begin with the header. Lindsay is going to be making red line changes on that. And as the chairman coming next Monday night, Dr. Brayman and Chief Rossler will come back with a document to to say this is what, you know, we would like to change, and if something that did not change, then they can discuss why. So on page one, and this is what we ask everybody to do, give the page number, the paragraph, and the reason why you want to make the change. And this is change the title to read School Liaison Commander, SLC, and School Resource Officer. It's our memorandum of understanding between the Fairfax County Public School and the Fairfax County Police Department. Tim Thompson and Shirley Jenright made the comments. Those are the reasons that are outlined there. End of discussion, yes.
The agreement is for the MOU.
Yes.
Between the superintendent and the chief regarding the duties and roles of several people, but to me that's confusing,
mm-hmm.
or misleading or out of order. Something doesn't sit right for me on that, because you start out with police staff, but there's also school staff. And just, I think the original wording is more appropriate.
I agree with her. I obviously didn't follow the instructions. I redlined and didn't put the comments in, but I struck out and procedures for the exchange of information and indicated it should be operating procedures within the Fairfax County Public School as a header. School Liaison Commander, SLC, School Resource Officer, SRO, operating procedures within Fairfax County Public Schools. I thought that was more appropriate than what I see as the heading now, talking about the exchange of information, because it goes way beyond the exchange of information.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought operating procedures within the Fairfax County Public School covered everything.
Okay.
And I should have put that up on, like I said, I didn't follow the instructions and didn't use the comment sheet that much. I redlined the document.
Okay. Could you just redline it in the comment?
Okay, where it says, and procedures for the exchange of information, I struck that out and I inserted, or I recommended that we insert operating procedures within the Fairfax County.
Read the entire statement.
Excuse me?
What do you want the entire title to say? Start with
School Liaison Commander, SLC, School Resource Officer, SRO, and then insert operating
mm-hmm.
procedures within Fairfax County Public Schools.
Sure, can I just ask a question that may be on the
sure.
minds of others, and maybe myself just new to this. Now, Randy, Tim and you, Shirley, presented
mm-hmm.
this. Randy's suggesting changes, and I get where he's going. Is it okay, is that how, what if the people who submitted it want to keep the language that they use?
We're having a discussion here.
That'll happen real time and just say,
yes.
Oh no, Randy, we don't want that change.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you get a document,
just learning.
When you get the document, you'll have one title. Okay.
But I guess I'm just saying, someone who submitted it, if they don't want a friendly amendment to the wording, they'll say so, and that'll just be a separate thing later.
Yeah, but the comments are from the entire committee. So the entire committee will have the last word on what we're going to change
okay.
to.
Yes,
okay,
I should put it in the comment sheet, not in follow the instructions.
Okay.
Yeah, Tim.
I just was going to say that obviously Dr. Brayman went to the Ed McMahon School of Segway, so I did well. The reason I put that in there for the education of the people here is I was not sure if a department in one organization and an elected body in another organization are the right parties with which to have this MOU. Should it be elected bodies of both sides, elected official, i.e. BOS and FCSB, or should it be the police department and the Dr. Braver and staff gatehouse, if you will, not the school board. So that's why I made the comments that I did, and it's more of a information and or have the lawyer look at it or something. I've done millions of MOUs, and your parties are always a parallel, they're on the same level. They're not two different kind of, you know, fruit and vegetables. They're both fruits, they're both vegetables. So that's why I made the comment that I did. And I don't know what the answer is. You all might have something that's different in the Fairfax County.
I did talk to one of the school board members about that, and they said there's an agreement between the school board and the Fairfax County Public School, Dr. Brayband, that they would, that he would sign this document.
I don't care who signed it, it's just, well, it would be the signature line, you're right, signature block. No, you're right, okay. That's fine, I don't care, I just pointed that out, because I wasn't sure.
So
I'm happy with whatever. Good one, Randy.
So the way it is now.
That was the easy one.
It is a memorandum of understanding between the police and the school as approved by the two governing bodies.
There you go, that works too.
Okay, hold on, Diane. So, Randy, is there anything else you want to scratch out? Is that the entire title that you're saying?
Yes.
So it would read school liaison commander as our operating procedure within Fairfax County Public School memorandum and understanding that we already have between the Fairfax County Public School.
And the Fairfax County Police Department.
Okay.
To be approved by the Board of Ed.
To be approved by the governing bodies.
Fairfax County.
Do you think that needs to be?
That's the reality right now.
So you want that as part of the title?
Put that in the title.
Chairman, that's going to be at the end.
No, there's also a signature block at the end. Okay. So I would suggest that we put that at the end as opposed to in the title. So I think it makes sense. Diane?
An amendment to the amendment in line with
tell us what you want to change.
Yes, and it's in line with an earlier comment. This is not merely operating procedures for the SROs. It does affect what school officials and personnel do as
so
well.
So would you like, is there something you want to add as a header?
Well, that it would be, you have to add, and FCPS personnel operating procedures, and then strike within Fairfax County Public Schools, or within the schools, because you would have repeated already the Fairfax County Public School personnel.
The personnel work for the public school, so I'm not understanding what you're
saying. Well, you could say, after the SROs, you could say, and FCPS staff, or employees, or
the point is to make sure that I don't know what the right language is, but the point is operating procedures. It's not just the procedures of the SROs and the SLAs. It's procedures of the school.
I looked at that title a long time, and it occurs many places within the text. I think the problem is that it's actually, you're talking about the SRO program. You're not, in the way it's worded, it looks like we're talking about an officer that is SLC, SRO, and in the body, you mentioned things like the SRO supervisor. You mentioned the principal, school principals, and things like that. So actually, it's a memorandum of understanding. If you have a title, it's the program, whatever you want to call it. I think you can get out of all these issues by just saying, let's give it a real name that we all understand, like the SRO program. So for example, the title is the SRO program, memorandum of understanding between the Fairfax County school system, school and the Fairfax County Police Department, something like that, and take out the titles.
Okay, repeat it.
I just say the SRO program.
Okay, repeat the whole thing.
Oh, so at the very top, the title should read the SRO program, : memorandum of understanding between the Fairfax County Police Public Schools and the Fairfax County Police Department.
Yeah. How would you spell out the name, not the initial?
Of course.
Not the acronym.
Right. Yeah.
Then you put the bracket so you could use the acronym throughout the whole document without having to do SRO or